Hello everyone, and welcome to this new video. The profession of interior design is about creating aesthetically appealing and functional indoor spaces. The designers establish their artistic touch and creativity by choosing suitable textile, furniture design, architectural technologies, and space management. Even though the major is just 100 years old, the first signs of interior design began to appear when humankind started to feel the need to decorate and enhance the living areas. And by that, I mean from the Stone Age and ancient Egypt to this day. The rise of middle-class society allowed the profession to rise to prominence, and its popularity rose even more during the Industrial Revolution. Interior decorator, moniker, craftsman, homemaker, and professional upholsterer are distinctly separated from the interior designer in terms of diverse tasks and missions performed by the interior designer, namely, the quest to make the best use of space, ensuring the well-being of the inhabitants and the functionality of the space. Nevertheless, they were all concerned about establishing artistic interior space management from the appearance of this major to this day. In this video, we will learn more about the various features of different eras and their impact on the current interior design. Starting with Stone Age, from 6000 to 2000 BC. The prehistoric human dwellings mark the first appearance of interior design. Essential tools and elements were used to decorate the occupied areas, such as plants, animals, skins and heads, sticks, and mud, which was the material of construction of the tribe's huts. Neolithic Europe, from 2000 to 1700 BC. In this era, handmade pottery was used for both practical and decorative reasons. This period is known for enhancing the geometrical sense of design. It added order, symmetry, and rhythm. Ancient Egypt, from 2700 to 30 BC. In this period, not only monumental architecture began to be constructed, but evidence of the emergence of interior design was also common at that time. Egyptian royal families were not sheltered in mud brick buildings and huts like civilians. They lived in buildings that mark the history of ancient Egypt. Moors decorated their buildings for the sake of portraying their beliefs and history. The ancient Egyptians decorated their indoors with furniture, vases, and sculptures. What about the Greek Empire? Well, this period of time took place in Greece from 1200 to 31 BC. The architecture of this era was seated in iconic pillars and impressive columns with imprints of harmony and proportions. Building construction was regulated with standard rules and procedures. However, for the interior design, silver ivory inlaid furniture ornamented the home of wealthy Greek. Nevertheless, regular people were able to ornament their homes according to their own style, thanks to advancements in civilization and lifestyles. Roman Empire, from 753 BC to 480 AD. The royals of this era showed their wealth through their ornamented homes with murals, mosaics, and furnishing featuring clawed feet. The Byzantine Empire, from 500 to 1500 AD. Well, the most impressive contribution of this era was the dome construction, church architecture, and iconic paintings. The domes and extravagant decorations were the center of Byzantine architecture and interior design. The Dark Ages, from 900 to 1500 AD. When it comes to the Dark Ages, the word dark is the most accurate word to use when talking about interior design in this era, which was almost thrown into oblivion. The people of this period opted for less decorated elements and preferred having paneled wood walls, stone slab floors, and not much furniture. Gothic, from 1140 to 1400 AD. So, what about the interior design of this era? Well, in contrast to the Dark Ages, the outstanding colors and decorative ornamentations prominently feature the interior design of the living areas. Open floor plans and the emphasis on windows for brighter space were the creation of this era, yet carried over through today, which allows the trends to never cease to exist. Commonly, the sculptural decorations and the architectural features were created using limestone, sandstone, and Purbeck marble. The Renaissance period, from 1400 to 1600 AD. While the design of construction plans introduced symmetry and order, interior design was presented in paintings of mythological and allegorical sculptures covering the walls. This era witnessed the different decoration elements such as florid decorative details, luxurious textiles like silk and velvet, marble surfaces, and carpets, which were used as wall arts because they were too expensive even to the wealthiest of that era. Baroque era, from 1590 to 1725 AD. In terms of shapes and forms, oval and elliptical shapes were preferred to square, rectangular, and circular shapes. Stained glass, twisted columns, colored marble, painted ceilings, gilt mirrors, and oversized chandeliers played a role in the expensive-looking interior design of this era. Those ostentatious elements featured the focus of the Baroque era, which revolved around flamboyance, splendor, and ultra-rich excess. In ancient India and around 1600 AD, the architect started to perform the work of interior designers. Rococo style, 1700 AD. Away from the limits of the confined and solemnity of Baroque style, Rococo style emerged with unencumbered interiors. Nevertheless, the interiors were extremely lavish, exhibiting elegance, delicateness, and uniqueness. This opulent style utilized flower-based design work and different materials such as tortoise shell and pearl embellishment on furniture. Asian porcelain was also used in home decor. The Rococo style is known for rooms decorated entirely in ivory-colored stucco, and their aesthetics were achieved through the use of light pastel colors paired with ivory whites, polished marble, gold, and silver. This aesthetic was maintained not only in the walls and ceilings, but in the furniture, flatware, silverware, paintings, and decorations to achieve visual lightness and luxury. Traditional, which appeared in 1700 AD. Thanks to the Industrial Revolution, the increase in education and trade, interior design was brought to the middle classes. They decorated their houses by showing off pianos, upholstered furniture, and books, taking advantage of the lower cost of rugs and wallpapers to prove their wealth. This era focused on antique furnishings, rich colors, and symmetrical room layouts, embodying a certain period in history, particularly based on 18th and 19th century European and American decor. Traditional interior design is still a mainstay to this day due to its broad term that highlights varied design style and movements. This style is timeless, evoking glamour, comfort, and history. The Industrial Revolution, 1760 to 1820 AD. The increase in attainability of luxury items and the wide distribution of fashion and lifestyle publications made it easy for so many people, more than ever, to be interested in interior design throughout the Industrial Revolution period. Neoclassical style, from 1780 to 1880 AD. The architectural details and motif of this style were inspired by ancient Greek and Roman cultures. This style was marked by using mahogany and window draperies, which were the main features of this style. The bronze and gold medals were used as furniture features along with silk, velvet, and satin while ensuring the matching wallpapers and furnishings. And what about the tropical style? Well, the tropical style appeared in 1880. And as its name refers, this style is inspired by coastal areas. Tropical interior design involved decorating with natural materials such as wood, rattan, wicker, seagrass, bamboo, palm, and teak. The use of silk, cotton, and fabrics featuring palm leaves, lattice prints, and cane motif in furnishing is also prominent in tropical interior design. And again, the colors are inspired by the seaside, food, and plants, including green, pink, blue, coral, and yellow. Victorian, from 1837 to 1850 AD. In this era, interior design became a part of everyone's life, not only the rich ones. The Victorian era was a time of innovation and creativity. It was known for its ornate and elaborate decor. The Victorian style continues to influence modern design ideas. The Industrial Age was one of the biggest influences on Victorian design. Furniture, art, fabric, and common decorative arts became easily and inexpensively made that resulted in the busy look of Victorian design, since it was the first time for all people from different classes to possess so many decorative items. They stuffed their living areas with furniture, hang art on all the walls, loaded shelves with books, and set decorative items on tables. This era gave more value to strong colors such as deep purple and glowing yellow, which were created thanks to the invention of aniline dyes. New printing and weaving techniques were also used in this era, allowing the usage of these strong colors to craft stunning plaids, stripes, and florals. Those techniques turned the Victorian homes into cheerfully colored spaces, showing in wallpapers, curtains, and upholstery. In 1800, the aesthetic movement showed up. So what is it exactly? The Victorian materiality, which revolved around fuzzy decor, curvaceous forms, and abandoned details, was rebelled against by aesthetic artists who attempts to promote the adage, art for art's sake, trying to separate art from the obligation to exhibit a social and political materialization, and maintained that art should not be confined to painting, sculpture, and architecture. The aesthetic movement refused modern industrialism and paid more attention to subdued colors, geometric designs, less detailed composition, and simplified linear forms. Tuscan, which appeared in 1840. The materials used in this style are marble, stone, locally made brick and terracotta mixed with woods, and textiles. Taken from the calming nature of Tuscany and influenced by Roman architecture and design, simplicity with touches of luxury were the key features of this style, combining comfort and elegance. Throughout the history of interior design, people from different eras have translated their artistic perspective and tastes into ornamented yet functional decors, being influenced by so many things that eventually shaped the appearance of their indoors. In part 2, we will carry on presenting the rest of the eras in which interior design developed even more to take a significant part in people's daily life. Till then, thank you so much for watching.